Gentlemen, I wanted to do a nice demo that you could do and follow along with me daily to help you bring blood flow for erectile dysfunction. And so follow along with me in this short segment that you can do both in the morning and in the evening to help aid the erectile dysfunction. What I have noticed in the clinic as patients have done these series of points is that over time, the points allow the patients to have not only a firmer erection, but also a longer erection. And again, everything that we are providing in these videos is to augment the medical care that you're receiving from your physician. I am not a medical doctor. I'm a licensed acupuncturist. I'm very good at what I do. Been doing it for 20 years. My name is Anita Tatavarthi, but you should have a great relationship with your primary care physician and get checked out. These can only add to whatever your doctor tells you. So keep that in mind. And I'm gonna show you three sets of points and we're gonna do them together. And we're gonna do each point for 2 minutes. And then you can do the sequence both in the morning and the evening. And also, if you check into my YouTube playlist for erectile dysfunction, you'll also see more additional sequences and you can mix and match. I want you to do a sequence in the morning and in the evening and do it consistently. Consistency brings consistent results. And once you've done it for a couple of weeks, my clinical experience shows that you will start to see results as far as a firmer erection and a longer duration. So keep this in mind and I wish you all the very best. The first set that we're going to do is to relax not only the mind but also the body. So much of erectile dysfunction has to deal with anxiety and depression. So the set of points that we're going to do on the face for the next 2 minutes is actually going to relax the mind and the body and is also going to bring blood flow to the genitalia area. What is the first set of points? It's pretty much I want you to massage from the top of your forehead all the way down to your nose and then to the side of your nose and then to the top of your lip and to the bottom of your lip. So we're gonna do this for the next 2 minutes. And you can also use an acupressure pen, which I'll do. I actually like the feel of it, or you can just use your fingertip, whatever you would like. So follow along with me and do this with me for the next 2 minutes. Here we go. That may have been a little bit more than 2 minutes. It doesn't have to be a perfect science, approximately. And you can do this laying down or in a seated meditation position. You can also do it before or after meditation to put you in that right space. Just also mention, we have a bunch of these acupressure pens or massage tools. You can Google either massage tools or acupressure pens. If you go to the description and click on our Amazon finds, you'll see a bunch of these pens that you can buy directly from Amazon that we have vetted. And then also just wanted to mention, the reason why this set of points is really important is the top of the forehead, actually the nose, and also the upper lip and the bottom actually represent the genitalia area. Specifically, the nose represents the penis. So in doing this, we not only relax the mind and the body, but we also bring blood flow to the genitalia area. So the next set of points that I want you to do is actually in the apex of the forearm. This is a very strong point, and I've actually seen quite a bit of results doing this. And I wanted to do this point after we go ahead and did the face points, because then you're a little bit more relaxed. I'm gonna take away this very flashy rubber band. So with that, it is pretty much massaging the top of the apex of the forearm. Now for this one, I'm gonna just show you using the pen, the acupressure pen or the massage tool, but in doing it, I'm actually gonna do it with my hand. And the reason why this is very important is that it actually brings blood flow pretty much all the way down from the top of your forehead all the way down to your genitalia. So this can be a very, very strong set of points. And so I want you to do this in the second of the 3 points that I'm going to show you. And we're also going to do this for the next 2 minutes. So follow along with me. And again, you can do this in a seated position. You can do this while you're after your meditation or before your meditation. You can also do it while watching TV. A couple minutes, a couple times a day. That's all that may be needed. And you can also do it a little longer. Doesn't hurt, only can help. And you don't have to do it in this perpendicular position. I'm just doing it for illustration purposes. You can do it when you're just laying, and you can actually massage the entire arm, and that's okay too. This motion is perfectly fine. You have the arm lay next to you and just massage it, because doing it in this position is good for illustration, but you'll get tired. So that's the second set of points. The third set is very much what put us on the map on TikTok with this. We got, I think, over 16 million views with the next one. So, and the reason why this point is really good is I actually learned this one from my acupuncture mentor, Dr. Richard Tan. And it actually helps with not only, according to acupressure in Chinese medicine, it can help with sperm production. So, you know, this is a good set of points for not only sperm count, but also for helping with erectile dysfunction. So with that, it's basically at where the palms meet. And the only thing I want to mention before we go into this point is that this is also the carpal tunnel. So I don't want you to aggravate it. If you do have carpal tunnel issues, then maybe consider a different sequence or a different set of points. You can pick and plug any of these sequences together. And I'm gonna do this gently. It's a very powerful point, so I do want you to consider it. But if you have carpal tunnel issues, then pick something else. But the point is pretty much like this. And it feels really good. Just gently massage for a couple minutes, a couple times a day. And we're gonna also do this for the next 2 minutes. I'm gonna also alternate and do this. Or you can simply do this too. So that was about 2 minutes. One thing I want to mention is because of the friction, your hands will be nice and warm. So one thing I like to do after doing any of these sequences is if your hands are nice and warm, take them and just simply massage this set of acupressure points. It will not only relax you, but it will also stimulate the endocrine function. And the endocrine function can help release or decrease the cortisol levels and increase the testosterone levels, which can be helpful if you're struggling with erectile dysfunction. And the last thing that I just would like to mention again is do this sequence in the morning and the evening. You can do any of the sequences on our playlist. Just do one sequence in the morning and then do one sequence in the evening. If you like a particular sequence, you can do that. And a lot of times with erectile dysfunction, a lot of the things that we talk about, we gotta release the anxiety and so forth. And so what I usually like to end with just a simple meditation, and we're gonna do this together. We're just simply gonna think in our mind for our, not only our mind, but our body, because they're connected. The mind controls the body and the body can sway the mind. We're gonna simply say, there are no obstacles in our path today. So say this with me for the next 4 times, and then I wish you all the very best on your health journey, and stay tuned for more playlists. So here we go. There are no obstacles in my path today. 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 And if you are getting ready to go to bed doing the sequence, just simply say, as I lay here tonight, my body rests. 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 I wish you all the best on your health journey.